In this course, we'll be building our own data structures and writing algorithms that leverage them, and we'll be doing it in Swift. The Swift standard library will provide our basic building blocks. We'll use Swift's own primary data structures along with their properties and methods to help build many of the data structures in this course. With that in mind, let's review some of the traits of two of Swift's data structures.
An array is a general-purpose, generic collection that stores elements in an order. Generic, in this case, means the elements in an array can be any type. The data structures you build in this course will be generic as well. Swift defines many capabilities of data structures, including arrays, with protocols. For example, you can iterate through arrays because they conform to the sequence protocol. You can do that multiple times and subscript into arrays because they also conform to collection. You'll create some of your own protocols in this course and leverage some additional protocols from the Swift standard library to define capabilities for your own data structures. When you're considering any data structure, there are some specific capabilities to be aware of. First, is the data structure ordered? How is it ordered? Elements in an array are explicitly ordered. Arrays use a zero-based index system to maintain that order, storing one element at each index, and allow you to access elements at any given index. That simple power to maintain order shouldn't be taken for granted. We're depending on it throughout the course. In the introduction, you learned about constant time. Random access collections allow you to retrieve elements in constant time. The size of the collection is irrelevant. Not all data structures have that capability.
There are other aspects of performance you should consider, like how does a data structure handle adding or removing data? With arrays, there are two factors at play. First, where are you trying to insert or remove an element? Remember, arrays employ that zero-based index system to order their elements. So if you try to add something at the front of the array, every other element in the array needs to shift over one index. You would have the same problem if you tried to remove the first element. Both of those would be linear time operations. Adding or removing elements from the end of the array, however, are constant time operations. There's no shifting necessary no matter how large the array is. The other factor is capacity. Does the array have enough space to add something new? Behind the scenes, arrays are given a predetermined amount of space to store their elements. If you try to add an element to a full array, all of the contents are copied into a new, larger container in memory. That can be a costly operation, so each time the array needs to add more memory, it doubles in capacity. With a Swift array, the answer to, is there enough space to add this element, will usually be yes. Overall, capacity doesn't affect the performance of operations on arrays.
There's another generic collection you should be familiar with, dictionary. Dictionaries are collections of key-value pairs and have some different characteristics. For example, unlike arrays, dictionaries aren't explicitly ordered. When you add something to a dictionary, you have no idea where it will be added. You can still iterate through a dictionary because they do adopt the collection protocol, but the order of elements will only stay the same until the dictionary is mutated in some way. That lack of guaranteed ordering gives you some performance benefits, though. While the time complexity varies when inserting into an array, inserting elements into a dictionary is always a constant time operation. Dictionary lookup operations are also constant time, whereas searching through an array gives you linear time.
Every data structure has advantages and disadvantages for a given use case. Arrays out of the box are fantastic as a base for data that must be ordered. But you might want to consider a different data structure if you find you're inserting a lot of elements to the front of an array. Dictionaries don't have the ordering capability of arrays, but they've traded it for quick insertion and searching powers. In this course, we'll introduce you to a variety of data structures, many of them building off of one another. As we go, remember there's no best data structure or algorithm, only better choices for the specific problem you're trying to solve.
Arrays and dictionaries are the building blocks of algorithms in complex data structures, not unlike likes for YouTube channels. So if you enjoyed this video, please do give it a like so we can keep the content coming. Cheers.